Previously on
Sarcastic Cheeseburger.
I'll have a tuna salad sandwich and an order of french fries, please.
No, no tuna.
You're out of tuna?
No tuna, you cheeseburger?
And you've always thought you couldn't bear press on nails because of all the active things you do? Well, if you're ready for beautiful, natural-looking, easy-to-apply nails, pre-colored in 7 luscious hues, just...
First, obviously, our thoughts continue to be with the family of Freddie Gray. Second, my thoughts are with the police officers who were injured in last night's disturbance. Point number 3, there's no excuse for the kind of violence that we saw yesterday. When individuals get crowbars and start prying open doors to loot, they're not protesting. They're not making a statement. They're stealing. When they burn down a building, they're committing arson. It is entirely appropriate that the mayor and the governor, who I spoke to yesterday, work to stop that kind of senseless violence and destruction. That is not a protest. That is not a statement. It's people taking advantage of a situation for their own purposes, and they need to be treated as criminals.
In a white room with black curtains, devastation. Black roof country, no gold payments, tired salaries.
Will you ever run for political office again?
No, no.
M to the A to the S to the K. Put the mask on the face just to make it next day. Feds be hawking me, jokers be stalking me. I walk the street and camouflage my identity. My posse in the Brooklyn wear the mask. My crew in the Jersey wear the mask. Pick up kids doing boogie woogie wear the mask.
Yeah, everybody wear the mask.
Yeah.
But how long
yeah. I used to work at Burger King.
Germs. Where did this sudden fear of germs come from in this country? Have you noticed this? The media constantly running stories about all the latest infections.
Coronavirus hit countries around the world, sparking public health emergencies in places as different from one another as Iran, Italy, China, and the United States.
The Salmonella, E. coli, hantavirus, bird flu, and Americans they panic easily, so now everybody's running around.
Yeah, there's a gasoline shortage. You know what else is disappearing from the supermarket shelves? Toilet paper. Ha ha ha, you can laugh now.
The lines are long and the carts are full. Across the country, people are wiping out shelves as they stock up to face the coronavirus. Soap is hard to come by, hand sanitizer and disinfecting wipes are gone. And yep, the toilet paper too.
The fight over toilet paper that went viral around the world.
I just want one pack.
No, not one pack.
You must give me your teepee!
We can all get enough toilet paper if we all calm down a little bit.
Scrubbing this and spraying that and overcooking their food and repeatedly washing their hands.
Again, from doctors, the best way to protect against the virus is washing your hands and social
distancing. Trying to avoid all contact with germs.
The coronavirus emergency and a reality check on how concerned you should be and what you should really do to protect yourself and your family. We're seeing a rush to buy those face masks, and TJ Holmes is here with more on that. Good morning, TJ.
All right, let me try to make it plain here, Stray. I have one surgical face mask here between the two of us, between me and Tom. He's sick, I'm not. Who should get the mask? Well, your natural instinct is to say, give me that mask. I don't want to catch what he has, but I should be begging him to wear it, because him, the sick person wearing it, better protects me, the healthy person, as if I were wearing it myself. So all these masks are floating around out there. Which ones do health officials say you should use? None of them.
People should not be walking around with masks.
Would you take that thing off? Take off that stupid mask.
Well, I'm just trying to protect myself.
But when you're in the middle of an outbreak, wearing a mask might make people feel a little bit better, and it might even block a droplet, but it's not providing the perfect protection that people think.
I think people see a mask and they see an illusion of protection.
Mask, where illusion is the ultimate weapon.
So we don't want people to feel like, oh, I'm wearing a mask, I'm protected.
Gloria, oh dear, I can't let her see me looking like this. I've got to put on my morning mask. I'll be right there, George.
But there's a growing debate over whether everyone should wear a protective mask when they leave their homes. And tonight, the CDC now advising all Americans to wear cloth masks to help stem the spread of the virus.
The CDC is advising the use of non-medical cloth face covering as an additional voluntary public health measure. So it's voluntary, you don't have to do it.
So Dr. Newman, you're saying that everybody wears a mask?
That's correct, Wendy.
But anyone to reopen would have to make sure that they walked into a business that had masks.
You use your federal leverage to mandate that though?
Yes.
And you would you?
Yes, I would, from an executive standpoint. Yes, I would.
So you would, in effect, mandate the wearing of masks?
I would do everything in my possible to make it required that people had to wear masks in public.
He's the man behind the mask, and he's out of control. He's back, the man behind the mask,
and he crawled out of his home.
Our impulses are being redirected. We are living in an artificially induced state of consciousness that resembles sleep.
No. Kneel before I saw it.
Can't believe I'm an accessory to a crime. We could get caught. I could get arrested. I could go to a girl prison. This freaking rocks.
We're waking up this morning to devastation in Minneapolis. Peaceful protests transitioning into violence.
Some buildings
and looting.
Up in flames, others serious heat damage.
An apartment complex that was under construction on 29th Street has burned.
Begun 8 months ago by a small group of scientists who discovered, quite by accident, these signals being sent.
The debate about masks, I know about a month ago you weighed in at first and you were saying, do not buy, do not wear masks.
The U.S. Surgeon General tweeted in February, stop buying masks. They are not effective in preventing general public from catching coronavirus.
Believe it or not, by wearing a mask, you could be putting yourself at even more risk.
What we're looking at is the mask that was used on the first episode of The Lone Ranger.
So the CDC is asking people to mask.
There is a fair amount of asymptomatic spread.
That asymptomatic shedders are probably driving a good part of the community spread.
Recent studies that a significant portion of individuals with coronavirus lack symptoms. They're what we call asymptomatic.
But from the data we have, it still seems to be rare that an asymptomatic person actually transmits onward to a secondary individual.
Look, on the top of the castle! Someone's there!
Help! Oh, please let go of me, you creep!
Dr. Fauci, thank you very much for joining us. You are now saying that you don't understand why all Americans are not staying at home. Have you told the president that you think it's a good idea to order Americans to stay home?
Oh, here you are, and here you will stay till they meet my demands.
I have said that...
There's a car coming! Scatter! Oh no, I didn't scatter!
What's cooking, Fatso?
Welcome to CHEESEBURGER.
You're touching your clothes. The clothes, sir. You touch everything. You touch your faces and everything else.
He's giving me a headache.
Yeah, tell me about it. Must took the hackers months to figure out how to do this.
Their intention to rule rests with the annihilation of consciousness.
The law tells us that we are going to have to make sacrifices. We are going to have to change our conversation. We're going to have to change our traditions, our history. We're going to have to move into a different place.
This week it's Robert E. Lee. I noticed that Stonewall Jackson...
Racial justice and human rights are non-existent. They have created a repressive society, and we are their unwitting accomplices.
I wonder, is it George Washington next week?
Overnight, a group of people tore down the George Washington statue in Northeast Portland.
And is it Thomas Jefferson the week after?
But that's what Americans do now. They're always willing to trade away a little of their freedom in exchange for the feeling, the illusion of security. What we have now is a completely neurotic population obsessed with security and safety and crime and drugs and cleanliness and hygiene and germs.
I'll have a big fatso combo with extra secret sauce.
Would you like apple pie with that?
Sure.
And the extra large soda for 10 cents more.
Okay.
Oh, and onion rings are free with all that.
I'll take them.
So let me read that back. One big fatso combo with extra sauce, an apple pie, extra large soda, and one onion rings.
You got it.
Sorry, we're closed.
Besides, what do you think you have an immune system for? It's for killing germs. But it needs practice. It needs germs to practice on. So listen, if you kill all the germs around you and live a completely sterile life, then when germs do come along, you're not going to be prepared. And never mind ordinary germs, what are you going to do when some super virus comes along that turns your vital organs into liquid sh-
Please understand, they are safe as long as they are not discovered. Keep us asleep, keep us selfish, keep us sedated.
They're pulling the
water. Existed for
destiny yet on the signs and out from your TV set. You will obey me while I lead you and with the garbage that I feed you until the day that we don't need you. Don't go for help, no one will heed you. Your mind is totally controlled. It has been stuffed into my mold, and you will do as you are told until the rights you are sold.
That I'm going to beat Joe Biden.